Hi guys, it's Sophia. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. I'm back to share some dies that I picked up from Inland Art Shop recently and some of the projects that I created using the dies. So this one here is a wreath die here, and it comes with two pieces, so you can cut it out solid in the center or use this piece here to cut out the center or for layering. So I thought that one was really pretty, and I picked out this die here, which is like little ribbons. And I did see Anne, who is Crafty Kimchi, make some projects with this one, so I thought it was really cute, and I knew I was going to be working with some birthday projects, so that one was fun to create and use. And then this one here is a frame die, and it's got this really cute leaf pattern on it, so I thought it was just really, really cute, and I like the size. And then it comes with this other piece here that cuts like a little border out, so I thought this one would go really nice with a lot of the crepe paper designs because of the way the leaf is designed there. And then this one here is a pocket die, and it cuts out this like geometric shape here, and then you just fold it over and it creates a little pocket tag. So I thought that one was cute. And this one here is a Gothic house die, and this one measures about 4.75 inches tall and about 2 inches wide across the top layer there. So those are the dies that I picked out, and I'll share the projects. Put these over to the side. So I used the pocket die to create these little tags here and made some other like mini tags to go on top with the sentiment that say happy birthday. And I just added some little bling to some of the little areas, and I did some fussy cutting from the paper. It has little strawberries and cute little animals and things, so I just did some layering there, a balloon, a little punched out circle there, and I added some pom-pom trim, and then just sewed around the edges. So there's this one, and then I made another one, really similar, just, and I like this here because this paper here was single-sided, so I chose to have the white as the top layer, and then like the pattern peeking through, so you can use either your double-sided paper or single-sided. I think looks really cute too. So here's the other one, pretty much similar, just another little tag with the sentiment, some bling in the center there, and another little balloon layered with a little circle with a pink edge, and then little ice cream and pom-pom trim. So similar little tags there. And on this one here, I'm not done embellishing it, but I was inspired by the embellishment box that I received from Bona for her design team with the flare buttons, and I wanted to create something similar using the letter stack. So I did that on top of one of these little Dollar Tree boxes, and I think it's turning out cute, but like I said, I'm not done embellishing it. But I love the way the ribbon dies look, kind of peeking out of the layers here in different colors, so I thought that was really cute. Excuse me. So love that one. And then for the Gothic house, I made some little just some little treat boxes that are ready to have some goodies put in here. And I do want to point out that the box, once you put it together, it does not have a bottom. I was thinking it'd be pretty easy to just kind of create a bottom if you really wanted it to have a solid bottom, but it's just kind of you know, doesn't have the bottom or the top, which for me, I'm planning to use some little like cellophane bags filled with treats and just kind of stick them in there. So I don't think it'll be a problem for what I want to use it for. I thought also it would be cute to put like a little tea light in there because it does have windows on the side and on the front, and maybe that's you know, part of the design. But if you really did want a bottom, that'd be pretty easy to just, you know, make one as you're putting it together. And then I just cut out some little animals and balloons with another die from my stash to make it into a party theme. And I love how they turned out. I really like the design on this one. And then here's the other one, just, you know, the same, just using different papers. And this one is double-sided, so you can see like the images popping through from the windows. So there's those. And then I did not do a project yet on this one, but I'm planning to either do like some small cards or even bag toppers with these. So I wanted to show you this one cut out just solid here in this one. And then here I did use the middle piece to cut out the center. So you can do it, you know, either way, or use the center piece here to kind of layer if you wanted an extra layer. So that's always nice to have options and more than one piece. And then my final share is the frame die set. So this is the little border that it comes with, and I just cut it out so you could see that. And then I decided to make some card fronts, and I didn't attach them to a card because I like to have these on hand sometimes. That way I can add it to a card, or I was thinking I could also add it to like a policy envelope or a little box, like a pizza style box. I was thinking, so just different things you can add it to if it's not attached already. So I'm leaving them like this for now. And I thought this one was really cute. I really do like the leaf design on the frame and the size of it. And then I just used the Maggie Holmes Willow Lane paper collection and some of the ephemera. Added some little pom-pom trim and did some layering and added tulle right here, stitching. So I thought that one was fun and cute. And then I made a second one, again using the Willow Lane, and I think you can see the leaf design a little bit better on this one here. And same thing, just I wanted these to be really simple and quick, so I didn't make it into a shaker or anything, but you definitely could do a shaker under there. And then I just did some ephemera, this one here, and a little butterfly with some gold string underneath, and these little heart bling right there, little gold hearts. So I thought these were really fun, and I did really like how they came out. And like I said, they could go on a card or a policy envelope or anything really. So those are my project, guys, and I thank you for stopping by again, and I'll see you next time. Bye.